subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates. Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to understand some of the gate bits which were asked on stacks and queues. So these are the year in which these questions were asked, 1996, 1997, 2004, 2015 and 1991. So we will try to solve this problem one by one. See here, this is our first question. Consider the following statements, consider all these following statements, which of the following are correct? Among these statements, which of the following are correct? And these are the options. We have to find the correct answers and we have to choose the choice, whether it may be A, B, C, D. Okay. So now the first question is, first statement is, first in, first out type of computations are efficiently supported by stacks. So how the stack will work? So how the stack will work is, suppose if you want to insert 10, 20, 30, based upon the operations that we have done in our stack, it is push and pop. So if we want to insert 10 first, so what is the first element that is inserted? It is 10. What is the next element that we try to insert is 20. So first in, the first in element is 10. So if you want to delete an element or if you want to pop an element from the stack, so for example 30 also got inserted. So from these elements, the first element that has been inserted is 10, the next element is 20 and the last element is 30. So if you want to delete an element from the stack, which element will get deleted? So which element will get deleted? Is it 10 or 30? So 30 will get deleted. So whatever the top is representing, that element there the operation will happen. Okay, the basic principle or the basic rule of the stack is the operation should happen only on the top. So based upon that, is it first in, first out? Is the first element that is inserting into the stack is coming out of the stack when we pop the element? No, it is not. So the functionality of the stack is first in, last out. So the element which has inserted first is going to be come out of the stack at the last. So is this statement true? No, this statement is not true. So the stack efficiently supports first in, last out. It is not first in and first out. Okay, so the next statement is implementation of list on the linked list is more efficient than implementing the list on the array of almost all basic operations. So the linked list can be implemented by using the concept of list can be efficiently implemented by using linked list. It cannot be done by using the arrays. So this statement is true. So what this statement says is, this statement is true. What this statement states is, the concept of lists can be implemented efficiently by using linked list. It is not done efficiently by using arrays. So the next third statement is, implementing queues on the circular array is more efficient than implementing queues on the linear array. So which one is more efficient? As we have discussed in our queues, the circular queues are more efficient. In what way they are more efficient? In what way they are more efficient is, so even though there are empty spaces in the queues, we cannot utilize those empty spaces by using linear queues. Whereas in circular queues, if there is an empty space in the queue, we can utilize all that space, which is not possible in a linear queue. So the circular queue of implementation, the implementation of queues by using circular array is more efficient when compared with the linear array. So this one is true. So last in, first out type of computations are efficiently supported by queues. So last in, first out. So how a queue will get represented is, so here these are the queues. So for example, first 1, 10, 20, 30 got inserted into the queue. What they are saying is, last in, first out. So whichever got inserted at the last is going to come out first. So how the queue operates is, if a new element has to be inserted, it has to be inserted at the last. If an element has to be, so insertion has to be done in this way. If you want to dequeue an element from the queue, the first element will get deleted. But what they are saying is, last in, whatever the last element that has been inserted is going to come out first. Is it happening in that way? No, it is not happening in that way. So how the queue works is, it is first in, first out. Okay, or in that way, if you want to mention, it is last in, last out. Whatever that has been inserted at the last is going to come out at the last. That is the principle of the queue. So this statement is going to be false. So among these four statements, what are the statements which are true? The true statements are 2 and 3. So from the choices, which one is the right answer? 2 and 3 are true. So this is the right statement. So coming to the second bit, which of the following is essential for converting an infix expression to the postfix expression efficiently? So among these options given, which of the following is more convenient and more efficient to convert an expression in infix to the postfix? So as we have go back to our video on infix to postfix, we have discussed it there clearly about which kind of stacks are used. So it is an implementation application of a stack. Infix to postfix conversion is an application of a stack. Which kind of stack is used? Is it an operator stack? Is it an operand stack? Is it a combination of operand and operator stack or a parse tree? Which one is used? So as we have discussed it there, it is an operator stack. So the stack that has been used, so the all the operators in the expressions will get inserted. Based upon some of the rules that we have discussed, we are going to push and pop the elements onto the, push and pop the operators onto the stack. Okay, so in order to implement infix expression, in order to convert an infix expression to the postfix expression efficiently, the better way is to use an operator stack. So the answer is operator stack. Okay, so the third question, the best data structure to check whether an arithmetic expression has balanced parentheses or not. So with a given expression, so this is one of the implementations of the stack. With a given expression, what data structure is more efficient to know that that expression is having balanced parentheses or not? So what is meant by balanced parentheses? So for example, if we take this expression, so is it a balanced, is it having balanced parentheses? What does a balanced parentheses means is, for every opening brace, there should be a corresponding closing brace. So for every opening brace, so for example, it's better we go with this, it's easy to understand. So what does a balanced parenthesis in the expression means is, whether that expression is having balanced parenthesis or not, how can we know? How can we know that? For every open brace, there should be a corresponding closing brace. So do we have the parenthesis in that way? So finally, we have to decide that whether the expression given is balanced in its parentheses or not. How can we decide? So what data structure, using use of what data structure is going to be better to say that the expression is balanced, expression is having balanced parentheses or not? So the better way is to go with stack. How can we say that? So for example, if this is the expression, how can we say that this balance, this expression is balanced or not? So what we are going to do is, we are going to take a stack. In this, we are going to push all the open braces. And whenever we come across with the closed brace, we are going to pop one open brace. From the stack. So finally, if there are no elements in the expression, finally at the end of this expression, if there are no braces in the if there are no braces in the stack, then we can say that the expression is balanced parenthesis, is having balanced parenthesis. Okay, so for example, or so for example, we will try to solve this problem. What is the problem? What is the rule is, insert push all the open braces. So we have two open braces, this one and this one. Those two braces will get pushed into the stack. So so whenever we come across with an open brace, we are going to pop one open brace. So here we got one open brace, so we got one closed brace, we are going to pop one closed brace. Again we got another closed brace. Whenever we come across with a closed brace, we are going to pop, sorry, whenever we come across with a closed brace, we are going to pop one open brace. So at the end of the expression, if there are no braces in the stack, if there are no braces in the stack, then we can say that the expression is having balanced parenthesis. So the better way to get this happen, the better way to know whether the arithmetic expression has balanced parenthesis or not, is the better data structure to be used is stack. Okay, so now what is the result of this post, the result of evaluating the postfix expression of this expression, what is the result that we are going to obtain? So as we have discussed about the postfix expressions in our previous video, please watch that video and come back here. If you don't know how the postfix evaluation works, please watch that video and come back here, because without understanding that, we are not going to explain it again. We are directly solving the bits. So the first one is 10. Next one, next what kind of stack is used by the postfix evaluation is, it is operand stack. Whenever we find operands, we will get they will get inserted. So whenever an operator is found, if it is a binary operator, do the operation and send it back, so that this is going to be 15 will be sent back. An operand is found, so push it onto the stack. Again an operand is found, push it onto the stack. So now an operator is found. Whenever an operator is found, we are going to use it here and this. So 60 by 6 is going to be 10. So after finding the operation, we are just pushing it onto the stack back. So the next one is what is this? It is a multiplication operator. So whenever we find an operator, pop two elements. If it is binary, pop two elements. This is going to be 150. So the final result will get transferred to the stack. Okay, so the next is operand. Whenever an operand is found, just push it onto the stack. So the next is operator. Whenever we find operator, we are going to pop it from the, we are going to pop, if it is a binary operator, we are going to pop two elements from the stack, and we are going to do the operation, and the result will get passed on to the stack back. So the after completion of the expression, whatever that is left in the stack is going to be the final output. So what is the answer, what is the solution for this postfix evaluation? It is 142. So the answer is 142. So coming to the next bit, the following sequence of operations are performed on the stack, and these two are 2 marks questions, and these three are 1 mark question. Okay, the following sequence of operations are performed on stack. It is push of 10. So assuming that this is the stack, we are going to push the elements onto the stack. Here 10 will get pushed, push 20. So the by the end of these operations, so after after doing all these sequence of operations, the sequence of values popped out is the way in which the things are getting popped out of the stack that we have to give. So the first pop expression has been pop function was called. So what will get popped off? 20 will get popped off. So we have popped out 20. Next is push 10. Next one is push 20. we are going to push 20, and the next one is pop. So whenever a pop is made, the first pop is made on 20, and now the pop is done. So pop is done means again 20. Next, so this one got popped off. Next pop function, with this pop function we are going to print 10. So this one will get popped off. This pop function we are going to print 10. So the three elements got popped off, and the next push is, next operation is push, we are going to push 20, and the last operation is pop, we are going to pop this 20. So what is the sequence of pop operations that are done with this sequence of operations is, it is 20, 20, 10, 10, 20. So the answer is B. Okay, so these are some of the gate bits that were asked in on stacks and queues. We will see some more bits on stacks and queues in our next video. So hope you understood how these problems can be solved. If you are good with all the videos that we have explained on stacks and queues, it is very easy to answer all the gate bits, or it is easy to answer your placement questions also. Hope you understand the explanation about these bits. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thanks for watching.